So I can do your, there's no more battery there. Okay, so the river pollution, okay, limited space, all these urban problems which we are facing constantly. Okay, now the difficulty, these are some of the real bad ones where people actually lose their lives because of overdevelopment in hillside areas, UK, accidents, crime. So these are the ways all this planning in fact affects you. It can even kill you. And some of you here today are really feeling it. Okay, this is a real tragedy. Totally could have been avoided. Without development to carry out where there's water running underground, they didn't care. We have tremendous flooding going on now. And you can hear the rubbish answers given. And not only here, I'm not here to say DBKL is the only one. Penang also a similar problem. Flooding all over the place. Land reclamation is carried out. And where is the hydrological studies to back it up? Anytime you interfere with nature, you don't do it professionally, you don't put enough thought in that process, you don't spend the necessary money, you don't look at the residents' interests, but you look at the developer's bottom line, you will cause this problem. There are engineering solutions to all this, but it costs money. And if it costs money, there are lower bottom line, because the applicant who wants all this will ultimately have to pay for it. So the trick here was to cut down all this, and therefore endanger people, because that's what actually happens. You know, drains, if you increase the population of Kuala Lumpur from 1.2 million to 2 million, this is about 2.2 million up to 2020, now I hear some harebrained idea of 3 million, 2.2, you must understand, it's like putting 50 fish in a small aquarium. If you're a fish keeper, kalau you simpan ikan, you tahu, kalau ikan ni 2, 3, 4 dalam satu tank, you terpaksa cuci, your filtration bagus. You don't have to clean the filter so often. You can clean maybe every month or so. You start putting 50 fish into the tank, you see what happens? You have to clean the filter all the time. If you don't clean, the fish will die. So this is the kind of situation. You want to increase to 3 million. 2 million pun, you cannot even prepare infrastructure. How are you going to do 3 million? So there's no planning. So who is this 3 million? I do not know. We don't reproduce so fast in Malaysia, so I don't understand.
Banglas.
Okay. So now, last time when I did all this, all the guys who used to protest were all the house owners. Kampung Kenchi, Rumah Terrace, in the front got condo. And yang condo ni, oh, you won't live in the city lah, you don't live outside, all that. Now the ones complaining are the condo. I got beautiful sea view. Nan laplas itu, one more block me, no more sea view. View of KLCC. So in the end, the single principle important for us all today, you come back with one lesson I teach you. This is what you should learn. The infringement of my neighbor's rights will ultimately be an infringement of my rights.
Yes.
So don't keep quiet when Datuk Kampung, Datuk Keramat or TDDI got problem, because I live in Bukit Damansara, I live in Bangsa, so that's not my problem. Yang problem now sekarang Bukit Damansara coming and nangis, baru saja. So anywhere, any place, regardless of where it is, where there's an infringement of their right, semua sekali goes masukong to say no, we don't agree, we fight out. If not, you are divided, you will lose. Kalau PJ senang ni, ini semua kita batal. Ini all the project completely batal. No hope of even getting through the first round. Not even the first round. Okay, because we will ask all of you, we will ask all the YB. YB datang for the meeting at the OSC. YB, apakah pandangan YB? So kita ambil kira. Lepas tu kita calculate. Dan kita minta RA, RT, bagi bantahan, ada hearing, ada dokumen.
Yeah,
apa dokumen yang minta kita bagi? Saya bagi. Macam saya chair, saya bagi. Saya bagi one SIA, social impact, okay, bagi. Traffic impact, saya bagi. Ada orang sini datang rule 5, minta SIA, TIA, dia tak ada langsung. Langsung tak ada.
Dia tak tahu.
Ha, ada dia panggil hearing. Apa ni hearing? Ini bukan hearing. Ini bukan cara you dengar warga negara. Okay. Oh, I hit something wrongly. Can you give me, just give me back the pipe?
Dumbbell.
Okay. So, what you need to know, understand is the law and what's happening now. When the government passed this book, like I said, 30 million saya tadi dengar. Saya pun tak tahu. Saya hairan. 30 million to prepare two set of book. Okay. Dia ada satu book yang dipanggil Rancangan Struktur Kuala Lumpur. Ini book masih berkuasa. Tapi ini book bukan detail. Ini book secara am dasarnya. Katakan hijau berapa peratus. Katakan kegunaan tanah, landscape. Dia secara am saja. Dia gunakan perkataan. Dia bukan banyak diagram sini. So after this, under the law, they must prepare this local plan. Very, very important. This is the plan that says where you sit here in the room, how far must this be, how many exit, how many aircon. All this goes through a very, very thorough process. I think I appeared 9 times before the hearing committee on this. 9 times. Okay? Planners involved, national physical plan, many, many government agencies, public participation. At first when it came out, I object against the whole plan. Because ni plan stress compact development. Dia main compact. I mean, tempat kecil dia mau padat. Dia cadang. Saya katakan, tak bayar. Kita banyak tanah. KL mungkin tak ada banyak tanah. Selangor ada banyak tanah. So kita must have linear development. No need. This is not like USA between one town, the other town. There's no urban slum in Kuala Lumpur. Kita speed saja boleh kena orang. It's very compact, very high density. So anyway, they went through all the process, everything. They zone everything for you guys. So low density area remain low density. Bangsa, only certain area high density. Your area TDDI, all low density. Your area in Taman Tun, very clear. This is the park. Semua dah ada sini. Very, very clear. Dah ada. Okay.